Hello guys, I'm KIRI, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about a 1965 Sunbeam Tiger V8. This model was in production from 1964 till 1967, and for the 4 years production run, just 7,083 cars were built. So it was a quite successful car because the designer was not someone else but a motorsport legend, Carroll Shelby. The car was designed and engineered in USA. And of course was using the great Ford V8 4.3 and then 4.7 liters engines, similar to the one in AC Cobra. But the assembly work was carried in England, and more specifically in the home of Jensen Motor Corporation in West Bromwich. It's convertible sports car, how you can see, with two doors and two seats only. Of course, it's classic configuration, front longitudinally mounted engine, and then the gearbox, shaft, and of course is rear wheel drive. How I said, the engines are from Ford V8, early versions 4.3 liters or 260 cubic inches, and then later 4.7 liters engine or 289 cubic inches. This is actually the engine from Ford Mustang, but only 633 cars were made from the bigger engine 4.7 liters. Only option was a 4-speed manual transmission, so wasn't option with automatic or 5-speed, just 4-speed manual transmission. The car is not big, actually it's a very small car. The wheelbase is 2 meter 184 centimeters. The car is long 3 meters 962 millimeters and is wide 1 meter 537 millimeters. Is high just 1 meter 308 millimeters. The weight of the Sunbeam Tiger V8 with V8 engine, of course, is approximately 1,200 kilograms. But when we're talking about Sunbeam Tiger, we have to say that the car is actual successor of the original British car Sunbeam Alpine, which was in production from 1953 to 1955 and then from 1959 to 1968. This was as well a very successful car with 69,251 cars were made, but the engines were more European sizes, and the early versions 1.5 and then they rise to 1.6 and later versions 1.7 liters, and the weight of these cars were approximately little bit over 1 ton, so 1,010 kilograms. But because they see a potential in these cars, that's why they decided to install the American big V8 engines. And of course, the result was amazing. So from Alpine, from Sunbeam Alpine, they went to Sunbeam Tiger with the V8 engine. And on the beginning, they make a contact with Ferrari to make them engines from Sunbeam. Actually, they make contact with Ferrari to make them engines a little bit more powerful, the 1.6 and 1.7 liters engine, and they were actually very near to make a deal, but on the end they decided to install American V8 engine. So this is how actually the Sunbeam Tiger came. And actually the Tiger, the model Tiger, was a development of the Sunbeam Alpine Series 1 introduced by the British manufacturers Rhodes in 1959. And with the bigger engine, even with the bigger engine V8 on the front, the weight distribution of this small car is just amazing. 52% on the front and 48% on the rear. That's why this car was very stable and very friendly to drive. Many customers actually they were happy to drive this car and to enjoy the car because the car was stable, absolutely amazing on the road. It's convertible, just two seats, it's light car, 1,200 kilograms, big V8 Ford engine, very reliable, nice sound from the exhaust. The weight distribution, how I said, 52 on the front and 48% on the rear, so this was just amazing to drive. How I said, so they skipped the project with the Ferrari to make the small engines 1.5, 1.6 or 1.7 more powerful, and I think they did a better idea to go to the American V8 engines. The gearboxes, first they were installing the BorgWarner 4-speed manual gearbox, but because they had many problems with the gearboxes, and then from Ford they supply gearboxes as well, so actually from the Ford Mustang in 1964-65 they supply the gearboxes as well, 4-speed manual. The power of the small engine, 4.3 liters V8, was 164, just 164 horsepower, but the car was absolutely dynamical car, the dynamic was just amazing. And mostly this car was exported to USA, just a small number, 750 cars were for the UK market, mostly, how I said, they were exported to USA. So the engine was equipped with single 2-barrel carburetor, so the compression was for the small engine 4.3, 8.8:1, and then they moved the compression for the big engine 4.7 liter to 9.3:1. The brakes on the front, they were discs 250 millimeters, on the back drums. The acceleration on this car, just amazing, from 0 to 60 miles per hour or 97 kilometers per hour with the small V8 engine 4.3 liters, just 8.6 seconds, and the maximum speed was 120 miles per hour or 190 kilometers per hour. And then for the US market, only for the US market, Mark II with the big engine 4.7 liter engine does acceleration from 0 to 96 kilometers per hour or 0 to 60 miles per hour, 7.5 seconds. So with the big engine acceleration, 7.5 seconds, even by today's standard, this is very good performance. And the maximum speed is 122 miles per hour with the big engine, or 196 kilometers per hour. But this big engine version was available only for the USA market. The price, new in USA, 1964, with the small engine, was $3,499. For the UK markets, in 1965, the price was 1,446 British pounds. Then Chrysler bought the company, and actually, this was the end of this beautiful Sunbeam Tiger. This particular car is just amazing. Is one of 750 UK Mark 1 car, but at the moment only approximately 400 were survived. The original color of this excellent 1965 Sunbeam Tiger was a light blue, but today the color is in this absolutely amazing yellow color. So, but the most amazingly, the worst owner of this car is since 1975, so imagine 45 years one ownership, just amazing. So this is absolutely beautiful car. You're just watching the car from any angle, from the back, from the front. It's just very beautiful. Just have a look from here. In this beautiful yellow car, on the front wing is the sign Tiger and V8, of course. It has to show the engine, V8 engine on the front. It's just amazing. Small car, less than 4 meter long, just for two people. Very, very beautiful. And with the two exhausts on the back, the car is just amazing. The sound, of course, of this 1960s Ford V8 engines is brilliant. Everyone knows the AC Cobra, how it sounds. So imagine this engine is very similar to the AC Cobra one. So the sound should be the same or similar to the AC Cobra one. The front with these round lights and the bumper with chrome bumper, the chrome grills, the indicators, of course, amazing. Just very beautiful convertible car, very, very beautiful. And the most important fact, how I said, is the design. Is the design of this car is from the motorsport legend Carroll Shelby. So all the car was designed and engineered in the USA, and that's why they decided to put, of course, this Ford V8 engines 4.3 on the beginning. This particular car is with the small 4.3 liter engine, because with the small engine was available only for the UK market, but with the big engine 4.7 was not available for the UK market, so only for the USA market. It's just amazing. And this classic configuration, again, the front longitudinally mounted engine, the shaft, the rear wheel drive, 4-speed manual transmission. Of course, the car is very, very enjoyable to drive. Just have a look from the front. Very beautiful car with this number plate, of course, 1975, the year in which the last owner actually bought the car, 1975. On the front wing you can see the sign Tiger, and under the Tiger you can see the V8, Ford V8 engine. Inside, the interior is just amazing as well. You can see a little bit later the interior inside, very beautiful. The fuel cap as well, you can see, is chromed, so very, very nice touch. The hinges on the boot as well, they are chromed. They are out of the car, so you can see them, absolutely beautiful. So inside the interior, outside, imagine yellow over black interior inside, just amazing. Black leather, black dashboard, the steering wheel is in black, and all trim on the middle with these nice round indicators. And how you can see the gear stick, usual from Ford. Very, very beautiful car. So guys, I hope you liked the video about this very rare Sunbeam Tiger V8, one of just 750 UK supplied car. If you like the video, please subscribe my channel, and see you next time, guys. Bye.